Dear children, today's class is numbers in mathematics, the class 4th standard. Okay, numbers. You have the numbers, single digit number, double digit number, and 3-digit number. So let us discuss about 4-digit numbers. Okay, and in this lesson, we learn about greatest number, smallest number, ascending, descending order, predecessor number, and succeeding numbers, and also we learn the expanded form in this lesson. Okay, children. So now let us discuss about the, which is the greatest and the smallest number. So you know, starting from 0 to 9, this is called as single digit number. Okay, this is called single digit number. From 10 to 99, 2-digit number. From 10 to 99, 2-digit number. Then 100 to 999 is called as 3-digit number. And then from 1000 to 9999. So this number is called as 4-digit number. So 0 to 9 is called as single-digit number. Single-digit. Then 10 to 99 is called 2-digit number. 2-digit number. Then 100 to 999 is 3-digit number. And then 1000 to 9999 is called 4-digit number. From this, we learn easily which is the greatest single-digit number and which is the smallest single-digit number. Here we didn't consider 0. So let us consider a single 1, who is a single-digit number. So here, which is the smallest number in the single-digit number? 1 is the smallest digit number and 9 is the greatest digit. Smallest number and greatest number. So take your pen and rough book. You have to write in your book. Okay, children. So which is the smallest single digit number? 1 is the smallest single digit number and 9 is the greatest single digit number. So let us discuss about 2-digit number. Here which is the smallest number? 10 is the smallest 2-digit number. Here 1's, 10's. So 2-digit number. Which is the smallest 2-digit number? 10. And then greatest number is 99. So similarly, 100 is the smallest 3-digit number. 999 is the greatest 3-digit number. 999. Like that, 1000 is the smallest 4-digit number. 9900 is the greatest 4-digit number. Okay, so we have to next up, 5-digit numbers also we have to write. So which is the smallest 5-digit number? 10,000. Which is the greatest 5-digit number? 99,999. See children, if you visit a shop, you purchase some things. For example, you the children, students, you purchase some books, pens, pencil. Is it right? The cost of a single pen is, for example, is 10 rupees. We call it as rupees. So this is a symbol for rupees. Rupee symbol is this. We call rupees 10. For example, you buy the one pencil. The cost of one pencil is rupees 5. Pencil rate is rupees 5. Like that, if you purchase a TV, it is about thousands in the terms of thousands. Or if we in your household, you purchase some things, for example, table, the cost of some tables are maybe 3000. So you call it as rupees 3000. Rupees 3000. 3000. Like that, we have to call the names. And here are some problems. We have to write the numbers with their words. Okay. So first thing, write these numbers in words. Okay. So once again, the one is the smallest number. 9 is the greatest single digit number. 10 is the smallest two digit number. 99 is the greatest two digit number. 100 is the smallest three digit number. 999 is the greatest three digit number. 1000 is the smallest four digit number. 9999 is the greatest four digit number. So write up to at least 6 digits, okay? In your book, you have to write down the at least 6 smallest and 6 greatest number. Write the numbers in words. These numbers you have to write in words.
Thousand. 14.
14. Okay. So again, like the case value chart, it is easy to write. Okay. Write 1000 days, 100, tens, and units. Observe carefully. In the unit case, we observe 14. So 14 here, 4 is in unit case, 4, and then in tens case we observe 14. So 1 is there. Means 1 means 10. 1. And then in the 100 case, there is no number here. See, 6014. So 14 comes under tens and units case. So there is no number in 100 place. So write 0. Okay? Write 0. 6000. Write in the place of 1000 place. 6. Answer is 6014. 6014. 6014. 0 in the place of 100. Okay, children? So this is a number. How to write in numbers? Okay? Next. Next one is, so open your page number 16 from your textbook. 1617, you have to fill in your pencil. See, here is a chart. You have to prepare a chart. Numbers that comes after 1000 and read. Here we have filled 101 to 1100. 1001, 1002, 1003, like the up to 1100. They will already so printed. You have to write next 1101. Next 1102. Like that, you have to fill these tables. Okay, children, this is the assignment for you. So page number 16 and 17, fill it with using your sharpened pencils. Next, let us discuss about the numbers, which is the succeeding numbers and preceding numbers. Succeeding and preceding numbers. So succeeding means success. Successor. Succeeding means successor. S U C C E E D R N G. Succeeding. S U C C E E D R N G. Succeeding numbers are the numbers. So when we add 1 to the given number, it gives the succeeding number, means the successor of the given number. So I will show an example. Example number 1. I will take 3876. So here is the question, which is the succeeding number of 2 3876. So for this, we have to find succeeding number. Add 1 to the given number. So I'll add 1 to the given number. The given number is 3876. So answer is, if you add 1 to the given number, so the answer becomes 6 plus 1, 7, and 7, 8, 3. Answer is 3877 is the succeeding number of this 3876. Children, what is the succeeding number or successor number means? When we add 1 to the given number, you get the number of, that is called as succeeding numbers. The spelling of succeeding number, succeeding is S-U-C-C-E-E-D-I-N-G. So like that, we have to learn preceding numbers. The spelling of preceding numbers is P-R-E-C-E-D-I-N-G. Preceding number. Preceding numbers means predecessor. You know, you learn in the last class, no? Last year. So preceding numbers means predecessor. Means before the number, we call it as preceding number. Here, how to get the preceding number? Example, 5,860. the preceding number of 5863. So for this we have to minus 1, means subtract 1 to the given number. So 5863 minus 1, you get the preceding numbers. So I will write in the working column 5868 minus 1. So draw the lines. 3 minus 1, 2, 6 as it is, 8, 5. So the answer is 5862. So 5862 is the preceding number of 5863. Okay, understood? So succeeding number means when we add 1 to the given number, you get the succeeding number. When we subtract 1 to the given number, you get the preceding number. Next, you know, already we have written numbers. Middle numbers means, so what the numbers in between numbers? So okay, right? The middle number. Middle numbers. For example, I will take 6896 and 6898. See children, observe carefully. In the unit place 6 is there, 9 in the tens place, 8 is in the 100 place, 6 is in the 1000 place. Like that, here 8 is in unit place, 9 is in tens place, so 8 is in 100 place, 6 is in 1000 place. Which is the middle number? So after 6 you get 7 here, is it right? And then after 7 you get 8. Like that we have to write 6897. So I will give one another example for you. So 99, and then which is the middle number here? So read the numbers 99, after 99, 99, 100, 101, 102, like that. So after 99 you get the number 100. So the middle number of 99 and 101 is 100. Okay. So this is the middle number, succeeding number and preceding number. Exercise number 2.1. So above that, do read yourself from page number 29. From page number 29. So you have to write these in your pencil, and also some feelings is there in your textbook. You have to write along with me or you yourself with your pencil. Okay. So first thing, write the following numbers in words. First thing from exercise 2.1. Write the following numbers in words. In words. First one, 697. 697. So write equals. Okay, write down in words. 6,097. N-I-N-E-T-Y-97. Second one, 809. 809. Third one, 9,899. 9,000 in the 1000 place, 8 is in 100 place, 9 means in tens place, 9 is in unit place. 9000. 9800. 899. So here are some problems from exercise 2.1. From first main, you have to write in your notebook. Okay. Second main, write the following numbers in place value chart. You know, place value chart. Second main, write the following numbers in. Write the numbers in place value chart. Place value chart. First one, 307. So write the place value chart here. So units, tens, hundred, thousand. Observe carefully, children. 7 is in which place? Unit place. Write 7 below the unit place. 0 is in tens place. 0 and 100. In the 100 place, 3 is there. So write 3 below the 100 place. So there is no 1000 place. Write it as is. Means give the blank. Next one. 5926. 5926. Unit place, tons place, hundred place, thousand place. So 6 is in 100 place. 6 is in 100 place. Right below unit place. Next 2 is in tens place. Next 9 is in 100 place. Next 5 is in 1000 place. The number is 5926. Next one. 8888. Write the place value chart. Unit place, tens, hundred, thousand. So in unit place 8 is there. In hundred place 8, thousand place 8 is there. And also thousand, hundred place 8 is there. Similarly, in the thousand plus 8 is there. So write 8888. So first name is write the words, write the numbers in words. And the second name is write the numbers in place value chart. For this you have to write the place value chart using your ruler. Ruler means scale. Using the scale and pencil, you have to draw the place value chart. Don't use the pencil. Okay? Use only pencil for writing the chart. Next, third name. So write the following numbers in words. So page number 22. So you have to fill the blanks with your pencil. First one. Third name, write the following numbers in words. So we will write 8001. And second one is 8940. So write down in words 8001. 8000. So in the 110 space, 0 is there. So write as it is 8001. Next, the number is 8740. 8000. What's this? spelling 240. F-O-R-T-Y. Don't write F-O-U-R-T-Y. The spelling of 40 is F-O-R-T-Y. 8,740. Okay, children. Next one is write the numbers which is represented in the picture on the place value chart and read. Next one is, so we have to write the place value for the given numbers. So they will represent in some pictures.
Write the succeeding numbers. Succeeding number means
1820. Second one is 3948. Third one 5201. 7605. Next, so what is the succeeding number of 6820? So already you know the meaning and what is the meaning of succeeding numbers. Add one to the given number. If you add one to this number, you get 6821. Okay, children. So write in your pencil or pen with your rough book. Okay. Now only you had to write. Okay. 6821. This is a practice. Okay. So this is a practice, sons. Do it yourself. And after that, you have to write in your classwork. Okay. 3948. For this, add one to the number. You get 3949. Next, 5201. Answer is 5202. Next, 7605. 7600. Which number I will write here? 6. 7606. So these are the succeeding numbers. So let us go to preceding numbers. Next 16. Write the preceding. So next means 6th main. Write the preceding numbers. Predecessor or preceding numbers means when we difference subtract one to the given number. So I will write in the rough column 4900 minus 1. So write 1 in the unit place. So subtract 1 from this. So here in the unit place 0 is there. What we have to do? So take borrow from the nearest place. So in the tens place also 0. So then we take borrow from the 100 place. So this 9 becomes 8. This 10, 0 becomes 10. So again we give borrow from the unit place. This number becomes 9 and this 0 becomes 10. So let us do the difference or subtraction. 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 what's here? 9. 10 minus 1, 9. 9 as it is. Here 8, 8 is in the 100 place, so 4 in the 1000 place. So answer is 4899, which is the preceding number for 4900. Preceding number, it means before number. So write 4899. So after number is 4900. Okay, clear? Next sum 5000. So what's the answer for this? So let us do the subtraction here. 5000 minus right 1 in the unit place. Okay, do the subtraction. Here 0. So you take bar from 1000 place. So this becomes 4. This 100 place becomes 10. But we give borrow to the next digits. So these two numbers becomes 9. You are already learning the subtraction. So this 0 becomes 10. 10 minus 1, what? 9. 9 as it is. Here also 9. So 4. Which is the preceding number of 5000 means? You get the answer 4999. So after 4999, you get 5000. Before the number is called as preceding number, right here 4999. So write 3827. So for this we have directly write which is the preceding number for this. Before 27 you get 26. So the answer is 3826. Here 4999. So 9 means you have to write 8. It means subtract 1 to the given number, you get 4000. 998. Clear, children? get succeeding number. When we add 1 to the given number, we get succeeding number. When we subtract 1 to the given number, same, when we subtract 1 to the given number, we get before number. So that is called as preceding number. Clear children? Next main is write the middle number. Is it easy for you? So write down. Practice in your notebook. 6th main or 7th main. 7th main is write the middle number. Middle number. First one, 2769-2771. I'll write the questions first. 5490, 5492. Next, third one, 3999, 4001. Fourth one, 5888. So 5890. So write the middle number for this. So this is the 7th main. So observe carefully, read the numbers. 2769. After 69, you get which number? After 69, 70. So the middle number is 2770. And then next number is 2771. So in this summary, observe carefully, 2769 is the preceding number of 2770. Clear? Preceding means the when we subtract 1 to the given number, you get the preceding number. 2771 is the succeeding number of 2770 is the middle number in between these two numbers, 2769 and 2771. So likewise, you have to write the middle number. 5490, the next number is 5491 and the next number is 5492. Here 3999, the next number children, 999, you get the which number? So for that confusion, if you add 1 to the given number, it gives the next number. And like in the last column, so add 1 to the given number, 9 minus 1, 10, 0, 1 is the carry, again 1 minus 9, 10, 0, 0, 1 carry, again 1 plus 9, 10, 1 plus 3, 4. The number is, the middle number is 4000. So, you can easily get the next number 401. Fourth sum is 5888. The middle number or the next number is 5889. 89 after the left, we get 90. So, which is the middle number here? 5889. Clear? So, in this main, means in the 5th, 6th main, you learn about succeeding and preceding number. Here, this is the middle number. The next main is, so let us discuss about the expansion of the numbers. Expansion means we have to expand the given numbers. Expanded form or the standard form. Standard form means when we expand the given number, you get the expanded form. When we write in the place value chart, means short form, you get the short form or standard form. Okay. So here are some examples, like chore board, for example, expanded form of the given number. So, example number 1. 2736. Okay, 2, 6 is in unit place, 3 is in tens place, 7 is in 100 place, 2 is in 1000 place. So write the exponent for the given number. So usually, you know, 2 is in 1000 place, and then as it is, so you have to write 2 into in which place 2 is there? 100 place. 1000. 2 is in 1000 place, right? 2 into 1000 plus 7 into in which place 7 is in 100 place. 7 into 100. Then 3 into how much? 3 into 10 plus 6 into 1. 6 into 1. This is the exponent form of 2736. So you get 2 into 1000, 2000 plus 7 into 100, 700 plus 3 into 10, 13 plus 6 ones are 6 into 1, 6. This is the exponent form. And one more sum, 9863. So 9 is in 1000 place, 9 into 1000 plus 8 into 100 plus 6 into 10 plus 3 into 1. 9 into 1000, 9000 plus 8 into 100, 800 plus 6 into 10, 16, then 3 into 1, 3. The answer 3. This is the exponent form. So from exercise number 2.2, here are sums. Exercise 2.2. See, children, from your textbook, page number 20, you have to fill with yourself fifth name of starting from third name to seventh name. Okay, this is the assignment for you. So wherever the blanks are there, you have to fill with your pencil. Exercise number 2.2. Write the following numbers in expanded form. In the expanded form. Into 1 how much is it? 0 into 100 is a 0. Plus 6 into 10, 60. Plus 9 into 1, 9. This is the expanded form. So next sum is write in the general form. Next one is write the following numbers in general form. So expand form means we have to expand it using the place value. Means their places. Here we have to write the standard or general form. General means it will be standard. Means short form. We have to write in the short form. First one is 1 into 1000 plus 3 into 100 plus 8 into 10 plus 5 into 1. So write the place value for the given number. First here I write the place value. Place value starting from 1000 place. Write 1000, 100, tens, units. See children. So in the unit place 5 is there. Because 5 into 1, 1 means in unit, 1 is in the unit place. So we have to write 5 in the unit place column. 5. Next in the tens place. 8 into 10. Here 10 is 10 means the tens place. So 8 into 10. So here we have to write here 8 below the 8 block. Next 100. 100 plus 3 is there. So write 3 below the 100 place. And then in the 1000 place 1 is there. 1 into 1000. So 1 we have to write below the 1000. So the answer is 1385. 1385. Clear? So one more sum is there. Second one. 4 into 1000 plus 0 into 100 plus 7 into 10 plus 9 into 1. So A we have to write the place value chart. Begins with 1000. So in the unit place, 9 is there, 9. See in the tens place, which number is there? 7. In the 100 place, see children, 0 is there. So 0 as it is, we have to write in the 100 place. So in the 1000 place, 4 is there, write 4 in the 1000 place. Answer is 4079. 4079. Clear? In the standard or general form, we have to write in the place value chart. So, if there will ask expanded form, we have to expand with the help of the places. The help of places. In general form, we have to write in the place value chart. We get the standard or general or short form of the given number. So here next one is place value and place value of the given number. So here also some fillings is there. You have to write. Now we have to write in your rough book. Now